Time to tell us what you want us to know. You were always very detailed in all you did. What happened? You left us without a word. I can't understand for someone who is so detailed in everything he does, why would you leave us without a word? That he left, that's how he left us. What happened to the dotting your eyes and crossing your T's that you would always do? Remind us that I want to make sure that I'm giving you all the information that you need. This time you left without a word. I was not advised of your plan. Well, I guess you didn't know. You spoke on the 23rd. I was with you on the phone for over 25 minutes. And all was cheerful. It was all love, happiness, awaiting the birth of Christ. You never saw that day. What happened? On the 23rd, you sent me a text and a little prayer for Christmas. I barely read the prayer before getting the news. Daddy is no more. What happened? Daddy, what really happened? I wish you had told me when we spoke on the 22nd that you were leaving me. I wish you had given me any indication that that was the last time I was talking to you. You sent me a text with a prayer. You didn't tell me you were passing. Well, even though it is hard, I mean hard, for me to accept that you are gone, I still want you to know that you left a son who really, really loves you. I may not have had the chance always to tell you this. But I want you to know that I love you, Dad. Thank you for being my dad. Everywhere I go, everywhere I've been in all my life, through my schooling, whenever I meet people who know you and they see me, they would always say this: you look like your dad. You smile like your dad. You talk like your dad. With all of that, no matter how distant I was, I always knew in my heart that I am my daddy's son. I love you. And I have always loved you. Thank you for being my dad. I will end by singing a song written by John Barker. The title of the song is "Thank You for Being My Dad." Thank you for your guiding hands. Thank you for making my dreams come true. You are an extraordinary man. And I hope you are as proud of me as I am proud of you. Thank you for giving me life. Thank you for showing me good from bad. I guess I'm only really trying to say thank you for being my dad. Even though the years drift away, I never took the time just to say, I love you, Dad. And I have always loved you. Thank you for being my dad. Thank you for being my dad. Thank you all.
Let us sing now together, count your blessings. Great is thy faithfulness and showers of blessings.
Thank you.
verses John 3, 16 to 18, and John 14, 1 to 3 and 27.
Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. Peace I have with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid.
It's appropriate, obviously, that we conclude this worship service with two of the most profound and important scripture passages in the entire Bible. These passages, if put like two weights on the end of a scale, would probably make the scale even. Because they are passages which give us a hope, not only for this world, but for eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only gives us, as we think of Pa'atem, as we think of his life, as we think of his commitment to Jesus Christ and the work that he did as a faithful disciple on this earth. He walked as a man with integrity. He walked as a man who had faith and instilled that faith into his children and into his grandchildren. He walked as a man who loved his Lord, and he's left his legacy for all who knew him. He was a disciple. And disciples are people who follow Jesus the best they can, even though they are weak. A long time ago, 2,000 years ago, Jesus was talking to his disciples. And he was sharing with his disciples, as he always did, the truths that they would have to endure and face in the days to come. And one of these truths that he instilled in them was the truth that he was going to be betrayed and that he was going to die and that he would be leaving them. Now, as any one of us would feel, as Pascal said, how could this be? I can't accept it. We can't accept death. It's too hard for us to accept. We can't get our heads around it. And of course, the disciples were distraught, filled with grief and anguish. And Jesus left them as he leaves us with these words. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go and prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. My peace I leave with you. Not as the world leaves, do I leave with you. My peace I give with you. Do not let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Those were words that Jesus uttered to his disciples, and they are words that have carried through the annals of time, through thousands of years, and have resonated on the ears of faithful disciples for two millennia. And those words are the promise of heaven. Those words take what we have today, take where we are today, and open the doors of hope, open the doors of peace, and open the doors of joy. I began this worship service with a call to worship that many might have thought was strange. I said, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Friends, we can rejoice because we know that we have a hope beyond this world. We have a hope in heaven. And I know that we will see Pa'atem again. You will see your grandpa. You will see your father. You will see your friend. If you believe in heaven, You trust in the promises of Jesus Christ, and you live your life with those promises in your heart. You will see. All glory be to the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, world without end. Amen. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. And we pray for your comfort in this hour, O God, and we ask that you would give us hope, that you would remind us that death is swallowed up in victory, and that because you live, we shall live also. We thank you, God, that you have given us families, that you have given us friends for companionship, and we acknowledge our gratitude for James Akpepa Aten. And we rejoice in the love and friendship that we have shared with Pa Atem throughout his life and ours. We thank you for those gifts of mind, heart, and spirit, which were uniquely his life. We thank you that he was a man who gave to others, that he tried to instill good values in those he loved, that he lived by example. We thank you, God, for his bright smile, for his happy ways. We thank you, God, that he was somebody who loved to live life to the fullest, that he cared about people, that he took so many under his wing. We thank you, God, that he was an advisor, that he cared for and loved his family, his precious children and his grandchildren. And we thank you, God, that he loved you, and that in his love of you, he instilled a deep love for Jesus Christ in his family. For your grace at work in his life, O Lord, we give you thanks, and for the good that entered the world through him, we give you praise. And we pray, dear God, right now that you would bestow your deep peace upon the Atem family, that you would surround them with your love and care until their grief is overcome in thanksgiving and victory. Almighty and eternal God, you inspire us with the example of men and women who hold steadfastly to your truth, looking to Jesus Christ as the author and finisher of their faith. Grant that we, sharing the faith and hope that directed them toward your kingdom, may come to dwell with them in your presence, there to serve and enjoy you forever. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who taught us when praying to say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. We will be singing a two-part song, Au Dernier Jour. Did I get it right? Oh.
When the sun begins to shine, and when the sun begins to shine, oh Lord, I want to be
that your Redeemer lives. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit keep guard over your hearts and minds today and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Everyone is invited to go to the reception hall, which is located in just outside of the narthex.
Thank you. thanks.
Nothing yet. Fish.
Maybe just one. Rice. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You want
Probably. That's so cool.